we're going to look at how to factor expressions by grouping. This is like the final step. You might have a problem that looks like this, but eventually this will be your final step, and I want to show you what this part looks like. So let's write the expression down. If you're counting terms, you're going to count the first big chunk of stuff and the second big chunk of stuff. So you've got two terms that you're identifying here. What do those two terms have in common? They have a y minus 2 in common, so that's a common factor. You're going to be taking that y minus 2 out and putting it in front. And then all you have to do is throw a set of parentheses around what you have left. So you've got the y minus 2 in the front, and what you have left is 9b squared minus 4. That's the kind of big picture for what we're doing, and you can actually solve a couple of problems that way, but let's look at how they look. So here is an example from the very beginning. You've got four terms, the CS, the CU, the SX, and the UX. You've got four terms. You're going to create two groups. So break those four terms up into two groups and then look at that first group and see what it has in common. It has a C in common. So C is a common factor in the first group. You can take that C out and write down the S plus U, what you have left. Look at the second group. What does that one have in common? That one has an X in common. So bring the plus down. X is a common factor in the second group. Bring the plus down with the X and write down what you have left, which is the S plus U again. Now you're at the point where you can see you have two terms now from the two groups that you created, and both of those terms have an S plus U, and you can take the S plus U, which is the common factor, you can take that out and then write down what you have left, the C plus X. That's your final answer, S plus U and C plus X. One more example. We're going to look at what happens when you can't just attack it right away. In this particular example, the first group, if you were going to do two groups, there's nothing in common in that first group. So you need to switch some terms around. It looks like the negative 8bd and the negative 40ad would be a nice thing to swap, because you'd like to keep it plus minus if you can. You've got a positive 5, a negative 8, a positive bc, and a negative 40. You'd like to keep that. So let's rewrite it with 5ac minus 40ad first, and then plus bc and minus 8bd. Now you can create two groups, and in the first group, you've got a 5a and a 40a, so everything is divisible by 5 and by a. 5a is the common factor in the first group. Take the 5a out and divide, and that leaves you with c minus ad. In the second group, you've got b as a common factor. Take that plus b out, and you've got c minus 8d as remaining. Looking at this new expression that you wrote, it has two terms now from the two groups that you created, and they share a c minus 8d. You can take, that's a common factor in this new expression, and you can take that out and write down what you have left, which is 5a plus b. And that is the final answer, c minus 8d and 5a plus b, and that concludes our factoring by grouping.